I'm here with this OMTech laser, and I really like it so far. I haven't cut anything with it, but just the whole like unboxing process and setting it up and how nicely it was packed. It came in a really nice wood crate. Everything was in good foam. Like even the rotary tool is in a nice chunk of foam. It actually took me like 20 minutes just to get the crate open. And then I got it out of there, got it up on the table, and I'm really happy with it. All the glass is covered in plastic. I'm gonna leave that on there just for a minute here. I'll get that off eventually. And yeah, I just turned it on for the first time. I'm gonna go ahead and get it set up in light burn, and then we'll go from there. I've got a few ideas of some stuff I wanna try with it, but we'll give it a good shakedown and test it and stuff. Let me just show you inside here real fast. So it does have a camera here. You can see, I think this is for the laser power right there. And you got the honeycomb. This is a drawer that comes out here. Well, hard to do one hand. There we go. So the drawer comes out, and that's how you put the honeycomb in. The manual is very clear about that, but of course I didn't read the manual, and I was trying to figure out how to get it in, and then I was like, huh, let's look in here. And I'm like, oh, okay, it just slides right in. So yeah, read the manual. It's a really nice manual. And then you've just got your water reservoir here for the built-in chiller. It did have some kind of liquid in it already. I checked it, it's full. Yeah, that's pretty much it. So we're gonna get this going. I'm gonna make sure once more that I got all the packing material and stuff out. I think this needs to come off. Oh, and while I'm thinking about it, this is for the blower fan that comes with it. It controls it. You've got, you know, fast, slow, you got timing modes, then you got the button to turn it off. This takes two AAAs. Yeah, so let me get this going. Okay, so I've got it connected in light burn, and we're going to try a test pattern just to see if everything's working good. I will say it was pretty cool. They came with, or it came with this wood, some cardboard, and some plastic. So I'm just gonna use some of that wood here for this test. Normally these laser companies throw you in, like, even for lasers this big, they'll throw you in a Ziploc bag of just like random small stuff. This actually gives you some pieces that are like the footprint of the work area, which is nice because then you can like dial things in on their material a little before you, you know, buy some of your own and stuff. Like, really nice. I've had 12 or 13 lasers now, and this is the first company that's given me a decent amount of stuff. There's a spider back there. I don't know if you can see him. He does not want me to get close to him. I tried to remove him. He's gonna get encouraged to get out now, I guess. So we're here in light burn, and I've just got the little test file. I've already went ahead and framed it to make sure that it's gonna go where I want it. So now we're just gonna press start. It's gonna send it to the laser. Sorry for the glare up there. I'm gonna go ahead and turn the fan on fast. I can confirm that it is now going. And now we just wait a while. You can kind of see some sparks going there. I do have a camera inside. I'll cut to that right now if it's a good angle. There you go. You can see some lettering there. And we'll just be back when this is done. I will say that when the laser's in use, this light is blue. When it's not, it is green. And then when there is some sort of problem, it is red. If you ever needed to do an emergency stop, you can just slap that, or you can kill the power here. While we're talking about power, there is an attenuator here on the back. So you need to set that up. This comes as another safety feature. You screw this in when you get the machine, and then the attenuator knob. And you wanna go ahead and turn that all the way over. And then you have to have the key turned to the right to operate the laser. But yeah, let's go ahead and let this run, and we'll be back in a while. Okay, so it just finished. I'm going to open this. And you can kind of see where we got to start here with the test. We kind of know where to dial it in. I'm already familiar with what to do with 50 watt settings though, so I'm gonna go ahead and get some good settings in here, and then we'll try something else. So I'd like to show you the camera real quick. You can see it up here. So then I can come in here to the camera control, and I can update the overlay, and I can see, you know, what's in my area. So I got the wood in there. Now it is a fisheye, so you're gonna get a little bit of weirdness, but not a big problem. It gives you a good idea. And then I can come in and I can see, you know, roughly where my thing's gonna be. And there you go. That gives you a pretty decent idea there. It's a nice little camera. A lot of these don't come with them. And it's nice to be able to see where you're working. So I'm just gonna do some tombstones here now. Tombstones, here now. I've got all my settings. I'm just going to double check everything and then we'll get this started. All right, we're spooled up again and we're going. Just going to keep an eye on it here. Everything looks like it's going great so far, though. I will say I really like this thing. Every new laser you get takes a little bit to like get used to, right? But this one's nice. Everything's simple. I didn't have to put anything together. I had to take some things out for packing. Let me get away from the sound a little there. So once I unpacked it, it's pretty much just plug it in, double check that there's liquid, all that. Hook it up to your computer, either with the app that comes on the USB drive, which is from Rurita, I think, or then Lightburn. I had a CO2 Lightburn license already, so good to go. And yeah, this thing's great. Like, I really, really like it. I even like this blue light on the front. Like, it doesn't do anything, but it makes it look cool. Whereas the last large CO2 I had, and even the smaller one that's a little bit smaller than this, it does 8x12, which is in the basement right now, mothballed. It just looks industrial and boring. And like, this has like almost Apple kind of vibe to it with the glass and the white, and just it's nice and it's sturdy. Everything's great about it. I really like it. And I'm just tickled by this fan controller. Like, it's so nice to just turn the fan on and off. But yeah, pretty happy with this. Once we get these out, I'll put them together and show them to you, and then we'll probably try some acrylic. I've not had good luck with acrylic in the past, so I'm excited to try it out on this. This is about done, but this fiber has moved up here to the arm. I just thought that was kind of funny. I really like this thing. And I'm not just saying that. This is my third CO2 laser, and I've had one fiber laser, two infrared diode lasers, and 11 or 12 other diode lasers. And this is probably my second favorite laser. Obviously, my fiber laser is my favorite because it can do metal, and I like to do metal stuff. But for wood and acrylic and everything, hands down this one. I like the way it looks. It just looks nice. It looks slick. And it just seems to operate beautifully. There's no charring. I think there in the corners, there's the tiniest bit. And I'm not worried about that at all. I can still dial these settings in a little, considering this is only my second cut. You know, every laser is a little bit different, so you need to dial in the settings. And this is just my second attempt and markedly improved over this test. My settings here didn't even cut through. Now I've got it actually cutting through. So yeah, I'm very happy. I'm gonna get these out and put together. I'll show you that. And then we'll get some acrylic in there. I would need to use wood glue on these for them to stand up, because the bases are kind of narrow and floppy. But like you can see, these came out wonderfully. You just put the two little pieces together, and then you get these nice little tombstones. All the cuts are extremely clean. Let's take a look at this one. Everything is nice. This is just gonna wipe right off. And you would paint this anyway. See, it just wiped right off. And yeah, I love this thing for wood. I've got a piece of the acrylic in there now. So let's get that going. I've been playing with the acrylic for a while, just experimenting. You can ignore some of these, but I've just been tinkering with different settings here, and I've got a cutout I like, and I've got an engrave I'm starting to like. I'm just gonna work on this a little bit more here. I'm finally happy here, done with the testing on this. Let's pluck these two out. I think this one cut out too. Oh, that one's gonna need pushed out from the other side. Let's grab this piece of oak so we can have a little contrast here. And there you go. First I cut it, and then I went in and etched it. You could do it the other way around, doesn't matter. Probably would have been smarter to etch it first than cut it. And this one I just cut. As you can see, it's kind of hard to see there. Let's get it against the black. Cut out nice. There's no melted edges, nothing, you know, that looks droopy. That skull actually looks really cool. I'm gonna have to make more of these later. Now, I would like to note that this does have a rear pass-through, Obviously, I didn't really think about that when I set it down, and moving all this is going to be a lot of work. So maybe in a future video, I'll take a look at the rear pass-through. You can pass larger stuff through here and cut it, but you have the walls in my way. So say you had something like this piece of oak that's just a little too long, then you could pass it through and do your stuff. Like what I would do for this is probably just cut a little off and then put it in there so it would fit. I do have some PLA, I 3D print, if you haven't seen the videos on the channel. And I just was curious to see how well PLA lasers. So I have two pieces of flat PLA I printed out last night. I'm gonna put those in there and test on them a little and kind of see if I can find some settings before I run out of surface area, because it'd be kind of cool to be able to, like, you know, engrave or etch my 3D prints, especially if I like give them away to subscribers or something, then I could put a little thing on there and, you know, it'd be kind of cool. Since this PLA is kind of light, I printed some of these little push down pegs. I got two different styles here. Gonna try those on there. I'm afraid the air assist is gonna blow the PLA around. So let me get those on there real quick and show you. The one size is long enough. This one size, I can only fit it in the big holes. There's also these like kind of smaller ones sometimes. So I'm gonna switch to just two of the purple ones. And there we go. Now this is pretty secure. It's not gonna go anywhere. And if I accidentally burn these, who cares? Cause that's like 3 cents of plastic, no PLA. You can find stuff like that on pretty much any 3D printing site that has STL files, or you could just design them yourself pretty easily. Just caliper the hole, there you go. But they're pretty handy to have. If you have a 3D printer, definitely print some up. If not, you can just like get them on Amazon or something for a couple bucks. I think I found a good PLA setting for engraving. Twist these out of the way here. Try to get you some light. Kind of hard to see, but this one came out very nice. Does not punch through, almost does, but mind you, this is only a few layers thick. I didn't want to print something huge, so if I was going to engrave something, I would use that. I'm so sorry, that's so hard to see. You just have to take my word that that one is pretty good. I tried down here in the corner and it didn't come out at all. This was 18 speed and 20 power, and then down here in the bottom was 8 speed and 15 power, and it didn't do anything at all. So yeah, if you want to test on a thicker piece of PLA, the 18 speed 20 power gives it a nice kind of embossed look. This is so hard to see because of the black. I probably should have done that on a different color, but yeah, you kind of get the idea. I'm very happy with this thing. Again, it's been the easiest CO2 laser. This is my third CO2 laser, and hands down, I would take this one over the other two any day. I actually gave one of them to my wife's cousin because I was like, get this thing away from me, it's frustrating. The other one wasn't so bad, but this is nice. No one's getting this from me. This is mine now. I really, really look forward to using it a lot, and I think it's going to be fun. I don't have anything to put into the rotary tool, but I really want to check that out, so check back in the future. When you're watching this, the video may already be up. I need to find something that I want to put in there. I'll go to the hobby store or something and kind of look around for like a little wood vase or something to put in there, and we can play around with that. But overall, I am extremely happy. This is the OMTech Polar 350. There will be a link in the description, a link in the sticky comment. And yeah, if you have one of these, like, get any tips or tricks or anything? I seem to have it all figured out, but I'm always open for some advice or something. What might you want to see me try with this? It's getting a little too late in the year for me to paint stuff. I had bought some nice graffiti artist spray paint that I've got over here on a shelf that I was going to do some stuff with, because I don't want to take the time to like paint, you know? I could just hit it with spray paint. But like it's getting into 40 at night, and it's like 80-90% humidity because the corn's still drying and everything else. And the leaves are, you know, coming off, so some of that moisture is going into the air. Not the best time to be spray painting stuff. Even inside, I can't keep it above or below like 50% humidity right now. So yeah, I love this thing, guys. Check it out. Yeah, I like it. See you guys in the next video.